Yes, Your Excellency.
You are welcome to your office. When we say your office, indeed it is your office. Our IDB president has nurtured this institution in the true spirit of the founding fathers, who emphasized on brotherhood, solidarity, cooperation, compassion, and respect. And these are the values that we will continue to cherish. And these are the values that we are going to put in here. So, thank you very much, and we would like to welcome you. The ribbon cutting will be honored if you can do that. What constitutes the IDB group? You can see the IDB profile is up there, and all the six affiliates, the five affiliates, are in sequence according to the year they were established. The Islamic Research and Training Institute was the first one to be established in 1981, after the IDB program was established in 1975. And then you have the Islamic Corporation for the Insurance of Investment and Export Credit. This is our MAIGA of the IDB, which does export credit insurance and also attracts, insures investors against political risk. That was established in 1994. Then you have the Islamic Corporation for the Development of the Private Sector. This is a dedicated entity for private sector development, and that was established in 1999. You have the ITFC, Islamic Trade Finance Corporation. It was established in 2008, but the IDB, as the president said, has been financing trade from inception. So for us, trade has been a flagship activity since the bank's inception, but because of the demand of inter-trade and member country-to-country cooperation, we, the IDB, the Board of Directors, decided to establish an autonomous body that will deal with trade. And then you have the Islamic Solidarity Fund. This is our poverty.
So we want all these members of the group to be active in Nigeria.
In Nigeria.
Not in names, but in operation and projects.
Yeah, exactly. So with your permission, maybe I'll take you on a short tour of the office, maybe for 5 minutes or so.
Five minutes is too much.
Okay. Meeting room where we have some video conference facilities. Okay. This is the office of the resident representative. Yeah. And that's my name, Abdallah Kiliake. Okay. Yeah, this is the office of the operations portfolio manager. This is Mayor Nyang. Yeah, he's from the headquarters, seconded here. As operations portfolio manager, he will have the duty to see all the projects that are financed by the IDB group in Nigeria. Thank you very much. Okay. Now not occupied, but it will be dedicated to the private sector. We expect a professional from the head office to come and look at the interests of the private sector before the IDB establishes a dedicated office in Lagos.
We want it to be active in all parts of Nigeria.
In Nigeria, exactly.
All parts
of Nigeria, not only Abuja.
Yes, yeah, it's very important.
Okay, thank you very much. This is the office of our executive secretary. Mm-hmm. And here we have the Yasmin Ahmed, who is our head of finance in the administration.
She's in charge of money?
Yes, she
very
is.
Very good. That's very good.
This is Dr. Ima Kashim. She's the human development specialist. She'll be taking in charge of health and education sector projects.
So, mashallah, female, very well represented.
Excellent. Yes, I'm happy to see
you. This is Nasser Yakubu. Nasser,
Assalamu alaikum.
This is Honorable Minister of Finance and the IDB President. He'll be in charge of water and sanitation, but also he'll be looking at all infrastructure projects. Again, all over Nigeria, not only here in Abuja.
It's a pleasure.
This is our small meeting room for the office. And this is Sabiu Awal. He's an agricultural economist. He'll be taking care of all the projects in the agricultural sector. Yeah. You have a very good role to play within the country's diversification program in 2009.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. And this is Ali Adam. He's a procurement analyst, a procurement specialist. You know, there's no project implementation without procurement. Procurement is very, very key. So he's our key man looking after all the issues of procurement. Thank you very much. The other offices are not occupied for the time being, but we appreciate for thank you very much. Please, can you follow me?
Follow you.
Yes, please. Okay. Now, we have finished the tour and we will welcome Your Excellency to please.
My name is Muhammad Jimmy Yushua. I am from the Communication Division of the Islamic Development Bank Group. Her Excellency, the Minister of Finance, Ms. Kemi Adeosun, the Permanent Secretary, Federal Ministry of Finance, His Excellency, the President of the IDB Group, Dr. Ahmed Muhammad Ali, the Executive Director of Nigeria at the Islamic Development Bank, the Vice President Sector Operations of the Islamic Development Bank, the Chairman of Jais Bank, our distinguished guests, delegates, members of the diplomatic corps, members of different donors and partners, you are welcome to the opening ceremony of the Country Gateway Office of the Islamic Development Bank here in Abuja. As you know, in Africa, we have a lot of interesting proverbs, and one of them says, the day never lies. Only the mother of the bride will be put to shame. And I'm glad that the day is here. It's a day we have been looking for the inauguration of this office, and I'm sure everyone is excited for the opening of this gateway office. So without wasting much time, I would like to go through the program. The program is divided into two sections. The first section, because the Honorable Minister has tight schedule, so she would have to leave early. So we'll start with the first segment of the program, and then we'll go through the second segment of the program. So please, we would like to call on everyone to remain seated while we go, we finish the first half of the program. So now I would like to have the honor to invite His Excellency Dr. Ahmed Muhammad Ali, the President of the Islamic Development Bank Group, to deliver his speech. Welcome.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Your Excellency, Honorable Minister of Finance of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, and the IDB Governor, Excellencies, dear brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I would like to seize this opportunity to extend the deepest appreciation to the people and the government of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, and particularly the Federal Ministry of Finance, for hosting and gracing this event, which is part of an ever-growing relationship between the people of the Federal Republic of Nigeria and the Islamic Development Bank Group. The hospitality extended to the IDB Group delegation is both memorable and very special. The presence here today of Your Excellency, the Federal Minister of Finance, is a testimony of that special and cordial relationship. The support and facilitation role by the government of the Federal Republic of Nigeria in the establishment of IDB Group Country Gateway Office is timely and highly appreciated. My special thanks go to the Federal Ministers of Finance, Foreign Affairs, Justice, Interior, and other government departments, including the Nigerian Customs and Immigration Services, and all other agencies for their support. Furthermore, I want to recognize and applaud the technical and logistical support provided by the country offices and the resident missions of development partners, including the World Bank, the African Development Bank, UNDP, DFID, and others in the process of establishing the IDB Group Country Gateway Office. I am confident that we will continue to work together in the service of the people of Nigeria, the whole Nigeria. Excellencies, dear guests, as you all know, the main mission of IDB Group is to strengthen the solidarity and economic relationship among its member countries. The establishment of IDB Group Gateway Office in Nigeria aims not only to reinforce the already excellent cooperation between IDB Group and Federal Republic of Nigeria, but also to see Nigeria, the largest IDB member country in Africa, as a platform for strengthening the socio-economic, technical, and commercial cooperation between the Islamic Development Bank and its member countries in the whole of Africa. IDB Group looks forward to Nigeria playing a key role in this regard. This role is indeed particularly important after the completion of the last portion of the Trans-Saharan Road, which links Algiers and Lagos. There is an urgent need to develop and implement an action plan in order for the countries along this very important road, including Nigeria, to benefit from this important infrastructure economically, commercially, and financially. The sixth meeting of the Trans-Saharan Liaison Committee will be held here in Abuja on the 10th and 11th October 2016. We want this occasion to provide another opportunity for IDB support in this process. In addition, Nigeria is the host of ECOWAS Secretariat, and this is very important for contributing to the regional cooperation and integration. The IDB group, through its gateway office, will extend all necessary support toward achieving these common objectives. Moreover, the Arab Coordination Group, which includes the OPEC Fund for International Development, the Abu Dhabi Fund for Development, the Arab Bank for Economic Development in Africa, the Arab Fund for Economic Social Development, the Arab Gulf Program for Development, the Arab Monetary Fund, the Kuwait Fund for Arab Economic Development, the Qatar Development Fund, the Saudi Development Fund for Development, and IDB is keen to further develop the partnership with Nigeria, in particular, and Africa as a whole. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, the Nigerian government's exemplary leadership and drive for national development through good governance and zero tolerance against corruption inspires the IDB group and other development partners even more. This determination will go a long way in fast tracking the implementation of development programs in Nigeria to benefit the most needy families and young Nigerians facing vulnerability of poverty and extremism. In this regard, the IDB group considers education sector and particularly bilingual education among its priority areas in Nigeria and a key tool to counter extremism. Other priority areas that the IDB will focus on is health, agriculture, infrastructure, SMEs, and regional integration. These are what we aspire to do as IDB group and what we stand for. The establishment of the Country Gateway Office in Nigeria will enable the IDB group to be more service-centric and closer to the Nigerian clients in both the public and private sector, thus serving them better and faster. The Gateway Office will also contribute to the development of business relationship between the private sector in Nigeria and the private sector in the other IDB member countries. We are glad today to inaugurate the IDB Group Gateway Office here in Abuja. However, it is very important to mention that your institution is keen to have activities and operations all over Nigeria. We invite all the stakeholders to fully utilize this service, the services of this office. Thank you very much, all of you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Thank you very much, Dr. Ahmed Muhammad Ali, President of the Islamic Development Bank Group. The next person to speak is Her Excellency, Mrs. Kemi Adeosun, the Honorable Minister of Finance of the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
Your Excellency, Dr. Ahmed Muhammad Ali, the President of the Islamic Development Bank, Dr. Mahmoud Doudsey, the Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Finance, the Executive Director of the IDB and former Minister for Finance, Mansour Mokhtar, the Vice President of the IDB, the Accountant General of the Federation, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to sincerely thank the management and the dedicated staff of the Islamic Development Bank Group for working collaboratively with the staff of the Federal Ministry of Finance to ensure the successful inauguration of this office. As you're all aware, Nigeria made history when it joined the IDB as far back as 2005 as the 56th member country. And today, another step of history is being made by the physical setting up of an office here in the heart of the Nigerian government in the Federal Capital Territory, Abuja. Distinguished guests and delegates, the inauguration of this office is an important milestone in the relationship between Nigeria and the Islamic Development Bank for several reasons. It will strengthen the cooperation and the cordial relationship between Nigeria and the IDB Group. It will bring the IDB Group closer to the people, and it will allow IDB to appreciate some of the challenges being faced in the development of Nigeria and enable them to collaborate better with the federal government of Nigeria in executing projects that will improve the living standards of all our people. And it will add to the pool of development partners with field presence in Nigeria and the international standing of the IDB with other multilateral development banks to mobilize significant additional resources for the development of Nigeria. And finally, it will further enhance our focus on implementation and decentralization of activities for speedy completion of projects and better impact of development intervention. I am aware that the management of the IDB agreed to establish a country gateway office on the premise that value additions to Nigeria will certainly increase by being close to its member countries. Physical presence and a closer and a frequent interaction will also increase the knowledge of the IDB group about challenges faced in Nigeria. As you all know, Nigeria is at the precipice of a new era in development, and we need the cooperation of our development partners. And I call, therefore, on the IDB to use its experience in mobilizing resources, as it has done in other countries, to support the government in our drive to diversify and reposition the economy. Distinguished guests and delegates, with the situation of in the northeast of Nigeria, I also call on the IDB group to work with the development partners in operationalizing the recovery and peace building assessment and the implementation of the recently constituted June 2016 plan for the revitalization of the northeast region. This entails addressing aspects of interventions relating to peace building, stability, and social cohesion to support critical productive infrastructure and service delivery and provide capacity building and program management support in national, state, and local government institutions. Distinguished guests and delegates, amidst the challenges faced by emerging economies, including Nigeria, they are potential and immense opportunities. Notwithstanding IDB's significant contributions in the past, Nigeria requires far more resources to enable it to address the challenges outlined. In this regard, we urge the IDB, along with other groups, other members of its group, and the private sector, to lend greater support to Nigeria. Recognizing the bank's increasing role, we wish to propose a scaling up of the concessional resources and increasing overall financing to Nigeria and other African member countries, specifically leveraging on its AAA rating. The IDB can continue to mobilize resources from the market for the benefit of all its member countries. Excellency President Ali, distinguished guests and delegates, let me conclude by expressing continued appreciation for the support of the IDB group in the development of Nigeria. And I would like to pay special tribute to the staff and the management of the IDB group under the visionary leadership of Dr. Ahmed Mohamed Ali for what has proven to be another successful and rewarding milestone in establishing the country gateway office. I would like specifically to thank Dr. Ali and to congratulate him in advance for his upcoming retirement after years of service to this august institution, which he has built and carried on his back since its inception. Your leaving marks the end of an era. And I personally would like to assure Dr. Ali that Nigeria will continue to lend its support and cooperation to the incoming president of the IDB, Dr. Bandar Hajjar. In your years with the IDB group, sir, you've been a mentor to many. You have taken this institution to the leading edge of the industry and it's the kind of record that any institution will aspire to achieve. Even more important are the friendships and the relationships that you have developed with personalities and communities over time. You'll be very, very much missed. Whether in or out of office, Nigeria will remain your friend. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, the Honourable Minister. What are friends for? Friends always standing for friends. Thank you very much. We would like to ask the guests to remain seated while His Excellency, the President of the IDB Group, and Her Excellency, the Honourable Minister of Finance, go to the conference room for the signing of the guest book, and then the Minister will take her leave, and then we'll continue with the program. So guests remain seated, please. The Honourable Minister and the President.
We have a small gift here.
This is just symbolic.
Thank you, sir.
That's it.
Oh, this one? Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Shukran.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
And this was from them to you.
I present this.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much for the conclusion of the first part of the ceremony. Now we are going back to the second part of the ceremony. So as people get seated, we have a little suvana, what in household calls Araba, a short video about the activities of the IDB group. So stay tuned, please.
Today's children are our future. But the challenges they face in the developing world are enormous. That's why, in line with the UN Declaration of Human Rights and the Millennium Development Goals, the Islamic Development Bank set out a vision and program to transform the landscape of human development. A vision for human dignity. A vision to be achieved by 2020. This is no easy task, but collectively the 56 IDB member countries have the capacity and the resources to meet these challenges, working together to alleviate poverty, improving healthcare and reducing disease and diarrhea, funding education and skills training, developing national infrastructures, improving irrigation and food security, and empowering women to play an active role in society. By securing strong and sustainable economic growth, the IDB will improve the lives of millions of people. Together, we are better placed than ever to realize our vision: human dignity for all. The Islamic Development Bank, providing resources, fighting poverty, restoring dignity.
Thank you very much. Now I would like to invite the Vice President, Sector Operations of the Islamic Development Bank, Dr. Mansoor Mukhtar, who is going to give a few remarks and also provide a testimonial about the person who is going to be our ambassador in Nigeria, meaning the country rep. Dr. Mansoor, for the top of
distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to welcome you all once again to the inauguration of this office. We're very delighted to have you honor this event, and there have been lots of speeches earlier, and I think that also we saw a short video of the Islamic Development Bank, as they say, the photos tell a thousand words. So I will not spend too much time, really, other than to welcome you once again to say how extremely honored and delighted we are for you to be here, but also to have to be able to mark or witness this occasion of commission in our office, which would really help enhance our presence here and strengthen our engagement with the country, as well as promote involvement of other member countries with Nigeria. We're very delighted that this will provide an opportunity to also improve our ability to deliver results, to implement our projects in a more effective and efficient manner. We have identified a very senior level person from headquarters, Brother Abdullahi Kilieki, who is an economist by training. Important contributions in various spheres of activities to come and head this office, and I would really like to invite your support and cooperation in facilitating his task here. I have to say he's also deeply committed to Nigeria and to help facilitating our activities here. We have gone ahead also to begin a process of recruitment, and we already have a few staff members on ground. Are any of them around, please? We have recruited sector staff in agriculture and health education, and we have staff that will help run our office in admin and finance. They were recruited through a competitive selection process, and the part of course, the assessment was in terms of their commitment and interest in supporting development, and I'm very delighted that we have these people with us on board, and together as a team, and with support from headquarters colleagues, and we also have a very senior level person, a country portfolio officer manager, Mayero, who is here for a period of time to help improve or look at how we could strengthen the implementation of our projects as well as provide technical support in the design of new projects. So with this complement of teams and with the support of headquarters, we are very keen to strengthen and scale up our engagement here. I have to say there's tremendous potential here in Nigeria when you consider the enormous challenges the country is facing, but also the renewed determination of the administration to face these challenges. In relation to other member countries, I have to mention that in terms of accessing the resources and products offered by the Islamic Development Bank, there's still a lot of potential. Even if we compare with countries like Senegal and other countries in Turkey, for example, the portfolio we have is several times bigger than the portfolio that is in Nigeria. But of course, the good news is that we have started engaging with the government, and by the grace of God, we will be able to beef up our operations. We are also very interested in supporting private sector development, and in that context, we have the private sector arm of the organization, as well as the group that the arm that facilitates trade and insurance and investment. So all of these will be mobilized and pulled together to provide the needed support for moving our agenda forward jointly with other development partners. With these remarks, I would like to once again thank you and my colleague, Brother Abdullah Kiliaki. I want to congratulate you for the successful inauguration of
Thank you very much. And the next item in my agenda, actually, a few words from the resident representative himself. So let's hear from Mr. Kiliaki.
Distinguished guests, I wish to stand on all existing the protocols. I wouldn't say much, but later on I'll come back to you again. But thanks, Mr. Vice President, Sector Operations, for your very kind words and encouragement. And we beseech you and the IDB management to continue guiding us in our daily endeavors for the good of Nigeria and all our member countries. I think before, as I say, I'll come back again, I think we need to see a 4-minute infographic that welcomes you to the office, and the infographic highlights very briefly the scope of the terms of reference for this office and what we intend to do. Thank you very much for now. Waiting to come back at a later stage. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Kiliaki, for the brief remarks. As the Minister of Finance said in her speech, that IDB officially, Nigeria joined IDB officially in 2005. But IDB has a lot of friends in Nigeria even before that. And for this reason, we would like to get a few remarks from some of them. Every person we see here is important, but due to the time schedule, we would like to restrict just to 3 people. Therefore, I would like to invite Alhaji Omar Mutallab, who is one of the friends of IDB, to provide his speech. But I've just been notified that prior to that, there is another video that is going to be shown, after which we will take the remarks from Haji Omar Mutallab.
Welcome to the Islamic Development Bank Country Gateway Office, Abuja, Nigeria, an offshoot of a leading development financing institution headquartered in Jeddah, the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. The IDB was established in 1975 to promote economic empowerment and social development of member countries and Muslim communities in non-member countries. IDB's modus operandi is an integrated one based on solidarity and South-South cooperation that combines project financing, trade activities, and technical assistance with twinning arrangements, capacity building, and cross-border ventures. The bank uses Islamic modes of financing in all its dealings. Over the years, due to emerging needs in member countries, the IDB has grown from a single entity to 6 autonomous entities that collectively form the IDB Group. Each of these institutions deal with a specific niche or niches, all of which champion the cause of human development by harnessing resources to ensure that people, not just projects, are the focus. IDB Group recognizes the need for adequate healthcare, quality education, economic independence, and good governance. Its commitment to member and non-member countries alike is rooted in its passion for the advancement of all mankind, not just Muslims alone. The IDB Group represents a transparent system, evident in its modes of financing or lending instruments, with no political, theological, or religious colorations. The IDB Group's impact is already rippling across Nigeria, with development projects like the National Program for Food Security, which was executed in 27 local government areas across Anambra, Yobe, and Gombe states. The interventions enabled farmers to achieve significant increase in yields, with an average yield increase of 115%. The average household income was increased by more than 150%. Apart from the National Program for Food Security, the IDB Group has several other projects at various stages of implementation in Nigeria. Strategically located in Abuja's Central Business District, IDB Country Gateway Office offers a warm yet professional environment where stakeholders of all backgrounds are welcome to discuss business opportunities both in the public and private sector, including project financing, trade activities, small and medium enterprises, SMEs, public-private partnerships, capacity building, and technical assistance. The office also offers technical backstopping to executing agencies and project management units, PMUs. With the resounding success of the National Program for Food Security, IDB applauds the federal government of Nigeria for emphasizing economic diversification and creating a healthy competitive economy through enhanced investments in agricultural value addition, along with infrastructural development and the exploitation of solid minerals. Looking ahead and planning for a future replete with a robust economy and an advanced society, IDB is working on multi-million dollar infrastructural projects in various parts of the country, as well as healthcare and restoration of livelihoods and livestock improvement projects in the Northeast and elsewhere. IDB also plans to build more capacity by sharing success stories and experiences from other member countries, bringing on board its traditional allies in the Arab Coordination Group and other private investors to contribute to the government's economic diversification drive. The Islamic Development Bank, providing resources, fighting poverty, restoring dignity.
Thank you very much. So we'll now take a few remarks from the three guests that will represent the audience, and then a few words about the role of the CGO from Abdullah Kiliaki, and then the permanent secretary, and then we close the session. So now I would like to give the microphone to Alhaji Omar Mutalla, 2 minutes to please share his views about his relationship with IDB.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم The Excellency, the President of IDB, the Permanent Secretary, Federal Minister of Finance, and the Vice President of Islamic Development Bank, and I stand by existing protocol. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. For me and for a lot of us here, this is the, should I say, the epoch situation whereby even before Nigeria joined the IDB, there had been a number of us, many IDB present here, who have strived to keep the relationship between the IDB and Nigeria together. Because of this, and I must say the assistance and support given by His Excellency the President, we have this very special assistance program, which was very widely supported by His Excellency. In this, before Nigeria joined, we had the country has benefited tremendously from a number of programs, mainly to support the, should I say, the efforts of many citizens of this country. And I must say that the assistance given by the president has been tremendous. I must say that the one person who spearheaded the whole issue about Nigeria's membership is here with us this morning. And he's no other than Professor Adebi, a very long established member of staff of the bank. It was through him, I must say, that a number of us really got the impression that, in fact, Nigeria's membership of OIC would only be more beneficial if we joined the Islamic Development Bank. And I'm pleased that you know, this effort over the years has been achieved through the former governor of the central bank, later Alhaji Abdulkadir Ahmed, with the Almighty God rest in peace, who a lot of us strived the formation of so many organizations and bodies that have assisted to ensure that Nigeria becomes a full member. I'm pleased to say that we are now the 55th or 54th member of the IDB, and I believe more and more countries are joining, and I believe that there is enough of different profiles of the IDB, and I would like to once more thank you all for giving us the opportunity to attend to this very important occasion. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Thank you very much, Alhaji Omar Mutalla. The next person is another friend of IDB from the Dangote Group, Engineer Mansour Ahmed.
As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Your Excellency, President IDB, the Vice President, the Permanent Secretary, Minister of Finance, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I stand on existing protocol. Let me first of all convey the appreciation of our President, Alhaji Aliko Dangote, for this invitation, but also convey his deep regret that he is unable to be here personally. Indeed, he is right now outside the country. I spoke to him last night, and he said, I must stay here wherever, because I happened to be in Abuja last night. He said to convey to Mr. President, and indeed to the guests here this morning, his most sincere appreciation and welcome to the IDB group for having this office in Nigeria. He recalled only recently the meeting he had with Mr. President and the expression of interest for the IDB and indeed the Dangote Group to work together. The President in his remarks highlighted some of the key principles that the IDB pursues, which include indeed not only integration but inclusion. And I believe that for us in the business community, these two words are today have very deep and important meanings, because no business can thrive at the global level unless it pursues the integration and inclusion, not only in terms of geography and demography, but also in terms of financing and resource mobilization. It is clear, therefore, that for us in the business community, the presence of the IDB here in Nigeria opens up and strengthens the access to diversified resources for the enormous activities that have to take place in this country. We are therefore delighted and happy that this office is now a reality. And we want to congratulate Mr. President and indeed the IDB team for this epic-making achievement. We thank you and wish you the best of luck. Thank you.
Thank you very much for these wonderful words. As you know, development work is work about partnership and friendship. And here, we are delighted that some of our friends that we have executed several projects with are here present, the World Bank and the African Development Bank. And they will be the ones to provide a few remarks before we close the occasion. So I would like to start with the World Bank rep and then the African Development Bank to say a few words and then we proceed.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. President, Honorable Dukos of SAP. I bring greetings from the country director, who is unavoidably absent. We congratulate you for establishing the, this office here and the work you have been doing in Nigeria. We have had opportunity to interact with some of your staff, even when the office was not yet established here, we've been discussing with them. And we promise that we will try as much as possible to bring about the real partnership, what we call partnership, working together to deliver service to the people. And the good aspect is that it is not only in Nigeria we'll be doing this, we will also be doing this from the West Africa sub-region of Africa, because the coordination of the World Bank program, regional program, is actually based in the country office here in Nigeria. So we look forward for working with you and working with your staff to be able to deliver the expected goal and result that you or your organization has been working towards to do for Nigeria. Thank you very much and God bless.
Thank you very much. African Development Bank, please.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm the main sense, my name. I am here representing our country director who had to miss this event. One of the things about speaking after someone is that you can also say me too. What my colleague from the World Bank said, I absolutely support. What I'll add to it is that we are also very pleased to see the IDB here. Prior to this, we have met with them, we have discussed many projects, many collaborative efforts that we're both looking forward to contribute to. As I speak, there is one already in the pipeline that we're discussing, and I am very sure that we will both bring this to fruition. We look forward to a strong collaboration and partnership. And all I can say is that the more, the merrier. Welcome to Nigeria.
Thank you very much for this wonderful words, Mr. Kiliaki. So if you can please briefly explain the role of the CGO, and then we'll take the permanent secretary.
Assalamu alaikum and good morning. Thank you again, Excellency President Dr. Mohamed Ali, Permanent Secretary and Lieutenant Governor, Honorable Mohamed Dusa, Honorable Shuaib Gambo, the ED for Nigeria, in the IDB Board of Executive Directors, Vice President Dr. Mansour Mukhtar, colleagues from the development community in Abuja and from the IDB headquarters, all other protocols duly observed. When I was welcoming the Honorable Minister, I did say that welcome to your office, and I wish to reiterate or echo the same sentiment saying to all of you that welcome to your office, the IDB Group Country Gateway Office in Abuja. When we say this is your office, we really mean it, especially to our government partners. As I also say that this institution has been nurtured and promoted in the spirit of brotherhood, solidarity, cooperation, compassion, respect, and without infringing on a member country's traditions and culture. We will try our level best to live to the expectations of this country and that of our IDB management. We believe that with the help of the Almighty, we are confident we will win the struggle for making Nigeria a vibrant economy. To the government of Nigeria, it is our duty as a country gateway office and as IDB to listen and serve you and all Nigerian stakeholders with respect, and we will seek and cherish your guidance. We will do for Nigeria what is good for this country and what the country wants us to do. to our fellow development partners, we will work with you. You have been in Nigeria before us. We will learn from you and capitalize on some of your diagnostic works and ground experience. Again, thank you very much, and we wish you a pleasant day. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Kiriaki. Now we would like to invite the Permanent Secretary of the Federal Ministry of Finance for his remark.
The President of the Islamic Development Bank and his team, the Chairman of Jais Bank, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. For me, as Nigeria's alternate governor at the ADB, today is it's one of delight for me. I'm extremely happy to see the opening of the Gateway Office and to welcome in particular Dr. Ahmed Muhammad Ali to Nigeria to commission this office. And to thank him and all the staff at IDB for making today a reality and for the very close relationship between the IDB and Nigeria. And as Dr. Muhammad Ali himself stressed to me, the relationship, strong relationship between Nigeria and IDB predates the membership of Nigeria. We became a member in 2005, but he pointed out to me that there had been a strong relationship even before then, and he pointed to the important work that has been done by others, in particular he mentioned Alhaji Muhammad Talib, Sheikh Lemo, Alhaji Aminu, and Tata, and others. So I'd like to thank them for nurturing this relationship up to this point, and to implore them to work even harder to make the relationship even stronger. The IDB Gateway Office has come at a very opportune moment when Nigeria is facing severe resource constraints, as we all know. Our people are going through a lot of problems, and we need to develop the country as fast as we can. And there are a lot of expectations, and the IDB is uniquely placed to play an important role. They have the experience, many of the member countries are going through similar problems to Nigeria, so they can transfer information and knowledge and resources. Nigeria wishes to diversify the economy, we also wish to diversify our funding sources, and the IDB can play a role given its position in the Middle East and other parts of the world. So thank you very much for making this a reality, as I said. And I want to assure you, on behalf of the Ministry of Finance, we are all ready to partner with you to do a lot more. The Vice President mentioned that Senegal has a lot more in terms of size of the portfolio. Not just Senegal, other countries as well, Morocco, I've seen Pakistan and others. So we can do a lot more. So, Mr. Kiriaki, your work is cut out for you, and you will have our support. And let's see a tripling, quadrupling portfolio in the very near future. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I think we are now coming to the end of this program. So many people, so many ministries, organizations, and partners have contributed in making this event a reality. And we would like to acknowledge them, from the staff of the Ministry of Finance, to the staff of the IDB, to the event management company, and everybody that has contributed. Most importantly, you know, in the world of communication and journalism, we have an interest in saying that if you have a tree and there is a leaf which falls down and there is nobody to report it, can we believe that a leaf has fallen? We can't believe it because there is no journalist there. So I would like to congratulate our journalists who are here. I can see NTA, FRCN, NANS, Daily Trust, BBC All Service, and all the others that are here. We really thank you for making it here, and we hope this event also will greet the newspapers positively tomorrow. Before we conclude, there will be a quick reception over there, so which is another important item, I believe, on the agenda, after which we will go downstairs. There will be a group photograph, and then we'll say goodbye. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. very important.
Practically find the family business, so the eldest son of the chair. He's a lecturer in King Fahad. He's a professor of finance. He actually came.
Tu veux pas?
Merci.
Today has been a culmination of a very long journey which started from around both 1975 when the bank was founded and 1987 when His Excellency Dr. Ahmed Muhammad Ali made a formal approach to Nigeria, Nigerian government, Nigerian business community with a view to establishing a relationship between Nigeria and the Islamic Development Bank. That relationship took a very long course. It which has been tremendously beneficent, but at this point in time, we are poised to unfurl the great benefits that will come to the country and to the region. One thing I've always understood, and I would like to re-emphasize here, is that as people say, money has no color, money has no religion. Islamic Development Bank is only Islamic in name. It does not discriminate along religious lines or in any other way. It is for everybody, Muslims, Christians, non-believers in religion, human, mankind. Now, I remember, I think it was in the year 2000, during the annual general meeting of the Islamic Development Bank, and it was holding in Benin Republic in Cotonou. The then chairman of the Islamic Development Bank was the Minister of Finance of Benin Republic. And he stood there in his speech and he said, look at me, a Christian, and I am the chairman of the Islamic Development Bank. There is nothing religious about this. It's development financing. So I stand here and I'm calling on all people, whether they are Muslims or Christians, to avail themselves with this great opportunity that is being unfurled today with the opening of this IDB office in Nigeria. Congratulations to His Excellency Dr. Ahmed Muhammad Ali for his tremendous, sustained, continuing interest in Nigeria. We best of health, and may God reward him for the great work he has done. We welcome the new president, the new management, and we welcome the new team that is working here with us in Nigeria. Thank you very much.
Okay, my name is Dambosho Aibu, the executive director representing Nigeria on the board of IDB. And we, alhamdulillah, for really witnessing this as far as activities of IDB in the country are concerned. With the country get to office, as both the Honorable Minister for Finance and His Excellency the President of IDB did mention, is an opportunity for us to build on the achievements that we've recorded so far, and really ensure that service delivery is done effectively and efficiently. With the situation in Nigeria, at least this is an assurance that the bank is really well positioned to get into serious business in terms of projects that are in the priority list of the country. You know, we are aware of the diversification drive by the country, and IDB has what the necessary resources to support the diversification program of the federal government to conclusion. The areas of priorities somehow have been mentioned, and they meet actually the bank's, you know, area of specialization. You know, we have the resources, like you said earlier on, to work with the country, you know, towards achievement of this laudable objective. Like has been mentioned also, we have up and doing coordinating partners, development partners that we do work with. So the resources availability for the project in the country will not be limited to what IDB has, you know, so that because of the excellent relationship that we have with the other development partners, we'll be able to get them committed, you know, in such a way that at least their own resources will also be made available. You know. So in a nutshell, what the head office now, what the country get office will now concentrate on is in seeing that at least the existing projects are receiving all the necessary attention, and the ones in the pipeline also are attended to within the shortest possible time. Thank you. Like I said, once again, we are grateful to Almighty God for making this occasion a success. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.